Salamta, Tina Yestelin, fellow Rastafari, and anyone that happens to join us this day today on this channel via YouTube, Rastafari Fellowship. Now, this is concerning some activity that takes place usually around the evening time, whenever the sun goes down. But before we get into that, we just want to make mention that this is, it's not to be, I guess, like advertising for these so-called conspiracy theories, and you know, although we know that some of those people will enjoy this this evidence, I guess we could say, but what we say to those peoples, those conspiracy theories, is that there are no such things as conspiracy theories. These are facts. These are truths. I mean, it comes down to so if you get to the bottom of it and realize the whole truth, and you know, conspiracy theorist people out there, that is in fact a joke. That is a matrix within a matrix to keep you entertained, but somehow feel superior to some of these other individuals that lack even that little amount of knowledge. And so, you know, get over it. If you want to deal with plain truth and obvious truth and reach heights that you can only, well, at this point, these such peoples which we speak of cannot even dream of such heights. So yeah, we welcome all the item to you know, to get a real overstanding of the situation and get over these conspiracy theories. So back to the topic, you know, planes, basically what we are exposing is that every night around 7 o'clock, we don't know how late they're out there, but we know at least up to midnight, we have a series of planes flying overhead. Now, we're not saying they're spraying anything because it's dark and we don't see, but they do fly. They do fly at low altitudes. We don't know if they come from the east or from the west, but we do know that they take flight patterns of 4 minutes off to one direction, and then they make a turn, a U-turn, go back into the next direction, which is whether it be east to west, west to east, but they do 4 minute routes, whatever the speed is, then I guess multiply that by the 4 minutes and or do whatever math you have to do, and that'll give you, I guess, the geography that they are in fact covering in these flights. But I mean, we just know that they're wasting a lot of fuel, and whatever it is that they're doing, we don't care. We don't expect them to tell us. Actually, we encourage them to keep doing what they're doing, because that, you know, we understand that they serve their Lord, their master, and you know, we do what we gotta do. And so just beware of what the I them do. So back to the topic, we are just simply exposing these truths, and but during the daytime, now during the day, we can say that these planes, and they seem to be different during the day, these planes during the day in fact are spraying whatever it is that they're spraying. We don't know if it's chemicals. We don't know. We don't actually even care, because in and through get touching Jesus Christos, we really have not, we have nothing to worry about in all sincerity. And so it really doesn't, I guess, threaten us. It doesn't offend us. It doesn't cause the least bit discomfort, to be completely honest. But it is our duty to put forth and bring forth these reports of truth. You know, this is happening. If ones want to investigate it, if ones want to inform I and I as to what it is, then I mean, feel free to do so. We really will look into the matter, but it's not to say that we're really interested in it, but we do seek to expose what little we know. Now, we do know that they are spraying something, because these are not the early 1900s where you had these, I guess, like less advanced, you would say, planes that maybe somehow shot out some kind of smoke. So that is basically not the case. They have certain patterns, and it's interesting because in Ehud, the first day of the week, Sunday, what the world fall system recognizes as Sunday, it seems that they do they do a lot of spraying because we wake up early morning, we step outside, and behold, excess of clouds, or it's they're not natural clouds, but routes, I guess trails, some would say chemical trails, we don't know. But we know it's definitely not a celebration. They're not blue angels putting on a spectacle. So basically, yeah, that's taking place now. Last note, during the nighttime, we've been able to number 8 at a single time, and that is, that is affecting our fuel prices, and that is, as a taxpayer, unfortunately, we must speak out against these planes, just hovering over the cities all night and 8 at a time. We just would like to encourage ones to look into this in the sense that that is our tax money. And lastly, and when we say 8, they're not all doing the same thing. Usually there's two just hovering over the city back and forth, but at times there comes one like at really high altitude, really fast, and then two other ones just tag along, and it's like they're having fun, and we understand. I mean, children that are not able to behave themselves in a manner in which they have been taught to do so in the Bible, we know that these kind of foolish individuals tend to put good technologies to bad use, whether it be pride or whether it be foolishness or just their lack of intelligence. And yeah, it's worthy to make mention that the fact that they have a certificate that entitles them to the title of intelligence, it makes them feel like they really are intelligent and like they are somehow illuminated, and therefore what they do is correct. But that all comes down to pride, self-will, which is the greatest evil. That is basically all we have to say. We just want to expose this. We know a lot of people know about this, but we just have to do our part to put this information out there and bring it forth. And so we give thanks to all for listening. Shalom to all Rastafari and to everyone else, I guess we hope that all goes well for the I them.